What's up, BTB fans? I'm going to be giving away two $100 Amazon gift cards every time we pass 1,000 subscribers. Find out at the end of this video how you can win. Make sure you subscribe and click the notification button. The music industry has always had a dark side. From singers caught faking their performances, bad business deals, heavy drug use and sex abuse within the industry, questionable suicides, and of course the pagan symbolism tied to Luciferian and Illuminati secret societies. There has been a progression in the blatant demonstration of these pagan symbols in music videos, but why? What is the motivation to constantly place pagan symbolism in all of the entertainment that comes out of major artists? I asked myself, is this some sort of expression of art, or could they be worshiping something that they believe in? If I use reasonable logic, I look towards the religious music industry, and I see that they constantly place symbols, for example, a cross, a dove, or a picture of God in their videos to show a form of worship. So if we question that it's not just a form of expression, what are they worshiping, and should we even care? I'll let you be the judge of that. Ariana's hit, God is a Woman, is laced with fertility God worship. Some of it is in your face, and some of it is tricky. Nevertheless, it's clear there is pagan symbolism in this video. But why? The theme of her video is fertility God worship. This was popular in the ancient days and can be found in most of old cultures. Some of the oldest fertility gods can be found in the Bible. The god or gods called Baal normally required the sacrifice of children, often the firstborn male child, by sacrifice of fire. Ashtoreth, a deity associated with sexuality and fertility and by some people's war. He was probably tied to the Mesopotamian cult Ishtar, which in turn was derived from the very ancient Sumerian mother goddess Inanna. The Hebrew Bible also calls the same goddess Astarte. Molech was also associated with child sacrifice in the Old Testament. If you are not distracted by the beautiful voice, rhythmic music, and pseudo-woman power message, you can clearly see Ariana is laying inside a purple liquid within the shape of a female reproductive organ. Here you see Ariana symbolizing the light or knowledge, which is very often associated with Luciferianism or Lucifer, who offered knowledge to mankind through Eve. Ariana is then seen on top of the world in a position of giving birth. In a sleight of hand perverted action, you can see Ariana select the eye of the storm and create a sexual gesture. At first glance, Ariana appears to walk on a rope with some peculiar looking balloons. Nothing really to notice, except when you take a closer look, the scene is actually representing Saturn, which is a fertility god worshipped in the ancient Roman Empire and still is worshipped in secret societies. The balloons are actually representing planets. They are not exact representation of planets, but you can decipher the different planets she is holding. It would be too obvious to have the planets scaled. Given the context of all the fertility symbolism, it is obvious what this symbolizes. The planets are there: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, and Ariana represents Saturn or Saturnus. But what is Saturn or Saturnus? This is a very, very deep subject that I cannot cover in this video, but I'll give you a little bit of information. Saturn is associated with negative, if not evil, significance. In ancient times, it had been called the Greater Malefic, which was opposed to Jupiter. Saturn is austerically associated with man's limitations, restrictions, death, and decay. He is also associated, or if not the same, Greek god Kronos, the ruler of time, time being the main factor, inevitably leading to the death of all mortals. Traditional representations of the Grim Reaper originate from the attributes of the god Saturn, who held the sickle with which he slain his father. At first, it appears to be an anomaly to the theme of the video, but it's not. Another clever way to add more fertility symbolism in the video. Here you can see a beaver comes up from a dried up lake bed and makes a hellish scream. Beavers thrive in lush lakes filled with water. In old ancient traditions, people would worship the fertility gods, making sacrifices for rain to fall so their crops would grow. Here you see even the animal kingdom is subject to her will by not allowing it to rain and drying up the lake. In the following scene, you see plants growing as she walks past the garden, indicating an obvious symbolism of fertility. Ariana is seen here in a triangle within a hexagon. She is behind a light and making a gesture of the female reproductive organ with her hand. The symbolic position is loaded with fertility symbolism and Gnosticism. The pyramid is referenced in Wicca witchcraft. The position of the pyramid Ariana is within would be referenced as the pyramid of spirit. In secret societies, the pyramid is associated with the levels of knowledge, and at the very top is the god of light or Lucifer. The hexagon within this context can reference also Saturn, as it has a hexagon on its pole that is still a mystery to scientists. In one of the final scenes, you can see Ariana singing on the top of a black tower. Ironically, light towers are never black. The tower is symbolic for light or forbidden knowledge. As you can see, whether a trick of the light or not, there is a pyramid inside within the light. Alright, so if you enjoyed this video and you want more content like this, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that is equivalent to the value of this video. Okay, if you want to win $100 free, all you got to do is subscribe, and then you got to comment on my videos and put $100 gift card giveaway. That's it. You're entered. You're all good. Thanks for watching, guys.